All right, welcome out, sports fans, to another episode of the Gridiron 64 podcast. It's Wednesday evening. We had Sinton athletic director, head football coach Michael Troutman on the Gridiron 64 yesterday. Today we've got Rockport-Fulton athletic director, head football coach Jay Seibert on the podcast. Coach Seibert, how you doing this evening?
Doing great. Appreciate All right. you having me on.
Yes, sir. And we're going to be talking about the big game. Of course, we've been pumping it up since Sunday here on the Gridiron 64. You got the Sinton Pirates coming in at 3-1, coming into Rockport Pirates Stadium to play the 4-0 Rockport Fulton Pirates. Going to be a great game. If you love South Texas football, Coastal Bend football, or if you just like Friday Night Lights, this is the place you want to be on Friday. It's going to be a great game between two great programs. So come on out. I mean, you can actually catch it on GT Sports, but you actually want to be like to feel it all. It's going to be a great game. Two great offense going at it. It's going to be great. So before we get into the questions, I want to introduce my crew. We are in full effect again. We got the big T, Tony Pena. Tony, how you doing, sir?
Good, man. Ready to get it going.
And then we got the Z-man, Johnny Zavala. Johnny, how you doing this evening?
Doing good.
All right. And then we got the coach. The guy that knows it all here on the Gridiron 64, Coach Steve Cantu. How you doing, Coach?
Hey, I'm blessed, brother. Happy to be here.
And, of course, like I said, we got a guest today, Coach Jay Seibert. Coach, how you doing? You doing all right?
Doing great.
All right. So we're just going to do a little Q&A with Coach like we did yesterday with Coach Troutman. And I'm going to go ahead and start it out with Coach Steve Cantu.
All right. Hey, first and foremost, Coach, welcome to the podcast. Happy birthday. All right. I appreciate you coming on. I know you're super busy and you guys probably got the whole night laid out already. So we'll try to get you out here just as quick as we can. My first question for you, Coach, is a little bit of the mental part of the game and, mostly the about the boys. My first question I got is what are some of the things you say to the boys before going into a big game about the pressures?
I actually talked to him about the day after practice. The biggest thing is it doesn't – when you play a football game, it's 11 guys out there against the other 11 guys. It doesn't matter if there's 6,000 people in the stands, 200, or if we meet on Saturday and nobody's there. When you go out and you play and you're a competitor, you don't really care about the outsiders. Those outside pressure, they may – or the outside noise – affects you, but once that game starts, you don't really notice how many people are actually there. You're just there to play, and so I just tell them, just take it as any other game. I feel like all four games this year we came out hot. We're playing at a high level. We're coming in the game ready to go. Treat it exactly like the same as you had the last four. I said, don't build up, don't do anything different. Just get out there and play and have fun. I stress having fun. The whole reason we do all these practices and all this weights and all the commitments they make is the whole thing is to have fun. And you have fun when you go out on a football field and you lay the emotions out on the table and you laugh, scream, cry, yell, and you celebrate when your teammates and something wrong, you concentrate on the next play and you move on and have a great time. And I want them to have fun. And I think if we go out there and have a lot of fun, we're hard to beat.
There you go. I've always found it a bit difficult. Of course, I deal with a lot younger age group. But for me, that's always been my biggest hurdle is that mental part of the game, a bad play, a muffed ball. I'm talking about softball. But, something goes wrong on the field and getting their head out of that last play. So,
I can go with that. We stress the next play mentality. Our big deal is the most important play is the next play. I talk to them all the time about we have a football game. We're going to drop passes. We're going to jump sides. We're going to fumble. We're going to own assignments on defense. You can't do anything about that. Once that's gone, most important play is the next play. Let's move on, concentrate on the next play, and let's go. And, I always tell them it goes over to life as well. If something bad happens in your life, if you stress on that and concentrate on that, something else bad is going to happen. You got to move on and concentrate on the next thing and make it better. And you know, so I mean, that's why I love football so much, is it relates to life in so many aspects, that the next thing you do is the most important thing you do. And so let's attack that. So if we have a bad play, and I always tell them, you know, coaches are going to yell at you. The fans are going to boo you. The other team's going to celebrate when you do bad. Stick together as a unit. Stick together as a team. Worry about the next play. Go win the next one.
Awesome. Yes, that's great advice. My next question, I kind of threw this one in there late, seeing how today turned out. And I don't know if you do much of the weather watching like I do, you know, my field of work. But are you guys considering taking any special preparations in case of the wet weather?
Well, today we practiced with the wet ball, and we actually, a couple of times, we threw it over in a water puddle and got it wet. And
there you go.
When we practiced offense, we practiced with the wet ball today. So we feel like that way, in case that happens, we're ready.
Yeah, absolutely. I think, you know, I don't know. I'm keeping my fingers crossed that, you know, Rockport usually has that bubble over it on Friday nights. I'm just hoping for good weather. And, you know, that way the game plays out, you know, best team wins, you know, that, you know, injuries, you know, look to be, you know, the same on both sides and stuff like that. And you wouldn't want that extra, you know, difference, I want everybody to have a fair chance and at a great game, you know, which I know it's going to be. My last question is, it's kind of silly, Coach, and I hope you don't get too much kicks out of it. But when we win on Friday, how long do you let that win resonate, you know, as a coach? You know, I mean, how quick do you turn the page?
I pretty much have a philosophy in the sense that every time we win a game, I'm happy, you know, and I celebrate it. I've even got a mentality as I've been a head coach for a while now, and I used to, if we didn't play well, you know, if you go back 7-8 years ago, if our team didn't play well, I really wasn't happy. Now I've gotten where if we win, I'm happy. And I celebrate that win that night. We come back with the coaches and we talk about it and we kind of, you know, have a, you know, a bond and have a good time with it. But most of the time, you know, Saturday morning, you know, when that clicks around, you know, we go over the game, but I immediately go back to work for the next week. I'm gonna have, anytime we win a game, I'm gonna celebrate it that night, and the next day I'm back to work for the next week.
Okay.
Now I will say, Steve, that you know, this is a big game, I'll probably celebrate Friday night and Saturday night this week.
There you go, Coach. Heck yeah. Hey, well, I appreciate you taking the time answering my silly questions, Coach, and I'll pass it on to Gabe.
All right, Z-Man, you're up.
Well, Steve kind of touched on the question I had about the weather. Obviously, it's going to be wet. I mean, it's supposed to rain every day. The chances of it raining for Friday has gone really up. You know, earlier in the week, it was 30%. We're up to 70% on that day. You told us a little about the preparation going into that game with the wetting the ball and stuff like that. Tell us about what's on your mind about that game, about being an ugly weather game.
I've been in some bad weather games, and really, it just, what level of bad is it? You know, we have a lot of game balls, so when we go in a game like that, we'll have good 8 to 12 game balls, and you know, we're pretty good about keeping them dry, and we'll have fans in there at halftime, and we'll bring them in there and put fans on them, and it's always nice when you have a bad weather game and you play at home, because you have all your facilities there to get your stuff dry. I've been in games where we come in at halftime, we change socks. I've even been in a game where we change jerseys, you know, and got dry jerseys on, but the because, you know, once you get a football uniform wet, it gets heavy, you know, where it's pretty light, and especially in today's time where these uniforms are so nice. But when your jersey gets soaking wet and your pants are soaking wet and your socks are wet and your shoes are wet, all of a sudden you weigh a little bit more. So it's nice to have your field house right there where you have extra cleats and you can change cleats, put a fresh pair of socks on and all that good stuff. But it doesn't take long before they're wet again as well. But you know, as far as the mentality there, it's wet for them, it's wet for us. You know, it's a deal where it's, you know, and we can sit there and worry about it, and you can talk about it if you want. There are times, you know, where as a play caller, you can get less aggressive, you know, because it's wet. You know, you want to pull your bit and make you a little bit more conservative. I think we're wet game. I would sure like to have like a 240-pound, 6-foot back that could close up the middle, but we don't have that. You know, it'll be what it is. Regardless, I think it's gonna be an awesome night and a good game.
Yeah, it's gonna take some awesome technique on tackling guys. You know, there ain't gonna be no more of this hand grabbing anymore. You know, you're basically gonna slip off. You know, so it'd be a game of defense by sure for that game. Yeah, I was gonna ask about, you know, how many balls y'all go through a game. That was, you know, I never knew that. I knew the NFL question. You know, I knew the questionnaire for that one, and I always wondered what through a high school game, how many balls y'all go. And he said 8 to 12.
No, on a normal night, you know, we may only use 4 to 5. But if it gets like that, you know, it depends. Some crews will check 8, but a lot of times when it gets wet, the official crews will let you check. You know, if you have a dry ball, they'll let you check it in.
I was just curious about that. Yeah. So I'm going to ask the main question that, you know, I'm pretty sure everybody wants to know. How big is this game to you? We heard it from Troutman last night. How big is it to you?
It's a big game. I felt like we got embarrassed last year. I guess you could say it was 52-34, 52, whatever it was. Yep. But I feel like they dominated us physically. A lot of times I don't really worry about exactly the score, win or lose. But I was kind of concerned that they were the more physical team, and we didn't like it. I told my coaches that next day. I said, you know, we're going to go to work, and we're going to go to work in a different way this offseason and through the summer, and we're going to train a little bit different. And we did. And I think this year we're going to be ready to meet that physical challenge. They have some great athletes, and so do we. So it's going to be a great game. As far as what it means to me, I mean, anytime you have the chance to go 5-0, anytime you have the chance to put yourself in the driver's seat to win a championship, that means a lot. Probably what more than what it means to me is what it means to my boys. That doesn't really matter. I'm not playing tomorrow night. I'm calling plays and I'm making decisions. But those 35 boys that are out on the field, and we call them young men. Most of them are young men now. Those 35 young men, it's if they want, it's how important it is to them, not to me. It's not. I remind my boys all the time, you don't play for me. You don't play for Coach Robbins. You don't play for Coach. You play for your brothers. You play for the guys you're in the locker room with, the guys you're sitting next to. If it's important to them and they put enough work into it and they want it bad enough, they'll go fight for it. And, you know, at the end of the night, win or lose, if they get out there and they fight their tails off and they play with pride and they get after it, I'll be a proud coach. You know, as far as what it means to win or lose to me, I've lost a bunch of games. I mean, I'll survive, but it's more on them, and what they want of it, and what they, because in the end, I could tell them all the time, I'm going to coach another 20 years, but a lot of these guys, this is their year, so they get what they get out of it, and so go get after it. I'm pretty positive. I'm willing to lay a lot of money. Can't promise you win or lose. But I know my boys are going to show up and play Friday night.
Good point. Yes, sir. Good point. I like that. I like that. I really like that. That's all I got, Gabe.
Yeah, and before I go to Tony, Coach, I know we're on the Gridiron 64, but we hope here in Rockport, the Rockport community, those next 20 years that you coach, it's here at Rockport, sir.
Amen.
I'm going to tell you that right now. You're almost reaching 10. So, you know, I said, hey, another 20 years, we'd like to have Coach Seibert here at Rockport. So hopefully that'll happen. I'm going to pass it over. Yes, sir. I'll pass it over to Tony. He's got a few questions for you.
How's it going, Coach?
Doing good, Tony. How are you?
Doing all right. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
So I'm going to ask you a question that I asked Coach Trauman last night. What or who do you feel is the biggest threat on the Sinton team that you feel that Rockport has to stop or has to shut down? Is it the offense in general? Is it a certain receiver player? Is it the defense? What are you keen on as a coach and as a team, saying we got to shut this down if we want to win this game?
You know, I mean, you know, the obvious answer to that is, you know, the two the those are amazing athletes, you know, but I don't think stopping them or shutting them down is probably going to happen. They're good. I mean, they're going to score. They're going to do some good things. But I think what we have to do is we have to put doubt in their mind. We have to let them know we're there to win. And we can't control what – we can only control what we can control. We can control ourselves and how we play. And, you know, obviously there's things that we want to attack. There's things that we want to stop. But the biggest thing we want is we want to perform at a higher level ourselves. And, you know, they have some great players. They have a great team defense that swarms the ball. They're good on special teams. They're a good football team. But so are we. And, you know, I had a guy interviewed me today, and, you know, and said, you know, you're going up against a good football team. And he said, but, you know, y'all are good too. And sometimes people forget that we're good. You know, and we're a pretty dang good football team ourselves. And, you know, there's things, obviously, we got to stop, and there's things that we got to attack, and we're going to get after it and do it the best we can.
Well, absolutely. And Coach Troutman did recognize your offense. He said that you ran that Rockport runs a slot T to perfection. He really, really reiterated that last night. And he talked about Chupe and how once he gets outside, how he's hard to stop. So he did say some really good things about you, about the football team. So yeah, Rockport is good too. This season, Rockport has been passing the ball pretty effectively. How much does the effectiveness of Aces passing go into play in the game Friday night? So how effective does he have to be? I know last year kind of struggled, you know, in the beginning, then he really got on a good rhythm. I mean, he passed for almost 1,000 yards last year. But, you know, John comes out early in the game last year. Luke doesn't play. And really, it was really hard to get the passing going. So how big of a deal is the getting the passing going going to be in this game?
You know, we kind of always, you know, and when I go into a game, we don't necessarily think, you know, we want to throw the ball. You know, the passing game's going to win, or we're going to do this. We're going to take what they give us, and you know, if they passing game, we're going to throw it more. You know, and if Chupe and Devan and Luke are carrying the ball for 10 yards every play, we probably won't pass much. You know, so we're going to do, you know, in previous games this year, we've had the luxury of being in the lead where we can try things. You know, I got probably last week where I got, you know, where I was running plays that we probably didn't need to be running, but, and, you know, I felt we're in a situation where if they failed, it wasn't a big deal. You know, obviously, we need to execute everything we do, and I think the passing game helps us all the way around. That the fact that we are a little bit better passing team than we've been in the past backs people up a little bit, and if you cheat up too much, we'll burn you. Ace is getting more confident, and Ace has gotten better after, you know, the season. And if you leave a receiver open, he's going to hit him, and we got some guys that are going to catch it and make plays after it. So, you know, I'm not going to understand we're going to throw it 10 times or 20 times, 5 times. You know, if we only throw it twice, that'd be great because that means we won. So, we're going to throw the ball around a little bit and do some things, but it'll be a fun night.
Right. So, also, last year you were out, Luke, and John went out, like I said, early in the first quarter versus Sinton. And Devan comes in and has a great game. He ends up having a great game that evening. How do you feel about having a seasoned Devan Phiilips this year and now adding John and Luke to the mix, a healthy John and Luke to the mix in this year's game versus Sinton? How big? I mean, you know, obviously it would have been great to have had them last year, and we don't like to make excuses that we would have won this game if they played, but what does it mean to you? What does it mean to the team, to them, to be able to say we're healthy for this game? You know, how do you feel the confidence going into the game, knowing that you have all your players?
Yeah, we're really healthy across the board right now, and you know, it's great when we can come in there and we're ready to go. We're fully loaded. We can't make an excuse. We're not missing someone. You know, if we don't win, we can't blame it on that. You know, and I said we didn't blame on that last year as well. I just said earlier they were the more physical football team last year, and they got us. Yes, anytime that you have all your playmakers there ready to go, and I feel like, you know, our offensive line is strong and ready to go, and our backs are good. We're coming in there. There's no excuses. Our guys are ready to go, and we're gonna give them everything we can. And yes, it is wonderful to have three backs that have a ton of experience. And not only are they great runners, but they're all three great receivers as well. And then they can get you that way. So it's exciting to see what they're gonna do Friday night.
Awesome. Absolutely. We all look forward to it, and you know, kind of what we're just trying to do, like Gabriel said, hype it up. We want to have as much support at the game as possible, because we believe that making the noise and you know, really lifting up the boys really helps them out. So we hope that we could get a lot of fans out there to pump up the boys and not really the hype about the game, but just pumping them up, because we want the boys to know that they got a whole community behind them. I know they know that, but that's why we're trying to get as many players there as possible. I mean, as many fans there as possible. So that's what this is all about. But again, Coach, happy birthday. Good luck Friday night to you and the team. And Gabriel, that's all I got.
Yeah, we wanted to kind of make it a little quick for Coach Seibert. I knew he had plans his birthday. He wanted to spend time with some family and friends. But, Coach, before we let you go, I just wanted to let you know, one of the things that's real impressive to me watching Ace is when he rolls out of the pocket. This is just my opinion. I think he's more dangerous than when he's in the pocket. I mean, because he can run and he can just chunk that ball 40 yards. It's pretty accurate, too. And so I do see how much more comfortable he seems to be in that offense, which makes it very dangerous for those defenses. And just every game is more confidence in him. With Jordan Gibson, you know, they've got a good connection, and you're seeing it. And it's just exciting as a Pirate fan to see, you know, we've got two more years with these two guys. Not to mention what Caden Kennedy brings, and just all the weapons this year that this Rockport offense has. And multiple guys that can come in, getting some of our main players some rest. And you bring in a backup, man, and that guy could be a first stringer on another team possibly. I mean, it's just a lot of weapons. And every week we just seem to be getting better. We've gotten a little selfish, Coach, where now we think we're going to score 60-plus points every game. You know, and when we don't get 50 and we score 28, we're like, wait a minute, what just happened here? And then somebody's got to remind us, hey, we still had a pretty good game. We're not going to score 50 or 60, but it's just great. I just wanted to let you know that it's just great. And the job that you and all of the coaches are doing with our football team, our program, is just excelling every year. We've talked when we had you the other time about one of the goals is, you know, getting out of that third round, but not just the football program, but just what you brought to Rockport consistently, where the other programs are winning. I mean, we bring up the volleyball girls now. We bring some of the girls on, and we've had Coach Jeffries on, and Coach Robbins, and Coach Clark, and just the job that they're doing. We want to bring some light to what they're doing, and just the opportunity that they have a chance to bring the district title in volleyball back to Rockport-Fulton, and so does our football team. So how exciting is that, right? And then we get into basketball and powerlifting and soccer. So it's just a great time to be a Pirate. And we're just the community of Rockport is really lucky to have you, Coach Seibert. We're winning consistently, and the guys are fighting hard. And it wasn't always like that in Rockport. So as far as a fan here in Rockport, I'm just glad that they hired you, because it's been great since you've been here. Like I said earlier, man, I hope you'll be here for another 20 years plus, Coach. So before we let you go, I'm going to take it around to the guys one more time. Anything you guys want to add before we call it a night? Tony?
Hey, go ahead.
I'm good.
Yeah. Steve, go ahead, Steve.
Hey, no, I have nothing to add, man. I want to try to get him out of here just as quick as we can. Thanks again.
Absolutely. Johnny?
Go take off that steak, and happy birthday, Coach.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Happy birthday, Coach. Thank you for spending some time with us. This video will be uploaded tonight. If you want to watch it, go to YouTube, GT Sports. It'll be there. And good luck, Coach, and we'll see you on Friday. Enjoy your evening with the family.
Yes, sir. Thank you all for having me on.
Yes, good night, Coach.
Thank you.